In this video, we will demonstrate how to easily edit logic and objects while online using the RemoteConnect Logic Editor and the SCADAPack X70 model RTU. You may need to edit a logic application at an operational site where shutting the site down to make changes may cause significant disruption. This may be to add new features into the logic, to fix an issue with existing logic, or to remove logic that's no longer needed. Or you may need to add or edit objects or variables. There are some restrictions which we will explore as we discuss and demonstrate online editing. There are several resources to assist you in learning what may or may not be done in online editing. A lot of good information can be found in the RemoteConnect help. I'll open it up and we'll go to the configuration manuals and SCADAPack X70 configuration, then working online with the SCADAPack device, managing the logic application in the device, and finally modifying a logic application online. You can find a similar page in the porting guide for Telepace to RemoteConnect. I'll expand creating a new project, creating a logic application, and then online editing the logic program. This walks you through the basic steps of modifying logic online. Before starting to do any online editing, here are some conditions to meet. First, the communication channel needs to use TCP, either USB or Ethernet. The logic debug service box needs to be checked. This is the default. The application in the RTU needs to be the same as in the RemoteConnect software. This can be verified by checking that different isn't displayed in the status bar of either RemoteConnect or the logic editor. And not surprisingly, you do need to be online with the RTU. Before looking at editing logic, let's see how to add an object while online. In Logic Editor, set the mode to Connect. This places Logic Editor in an online state with the RTU. Next, verify the Logic Editor status bar states equal, and the RemoteConnect status bar does not show different. In RemoteConnect, select the Configuration SPX70 Controller tab, then on the Objects tab, select Object Configuration. Now click the Add Object button. After giving the new object a name and selecting the data type, configure it with a TSPX70 logic variable type. This is how it is shared with Logic Editor as a variable. After you're done configuring the object, click OK, then apply the change. Next, move to Logic Editor and confirm the modification. You'll see that the Logic Editor status bar now shows Not Built. Now in the Build menu, select Build Changes. This option needs to be used so that the edit doesn't cause an offline state. When prompted, click OK to apply the modification. And finally, you can go to the Derived Variables folder to verify that the new variable exists. Now let's go through the procedure in RemoteConnect itself. First, I'll go online with RemoteConnect. I'm connected to a SCADAPack 474 via USB. Once online, we can see that the status bar indeed does not display different, so we're okay there. Now I'll open Logic Editor by going to the Configuration tab, SCADAPack X70 Logic, and click Open Editor. I'll go online here by selecting the Mode menu and Connect. Now that we are connected, we can see that the status bar states equal, so we're ready to proceed. Back in RemoteConnect, I'll go to the Configuration SPX70 Controller tab, select Objects, and then Object Configuration, and I'll click Add Object. I'll call this new object Tank1 Volume. And I'll set the logic variable type to an SPX70 real type. I'll then click OK and apply the change. Now you note the message states, please check the logic editor for messages. After moving to the logic editor, I'll click yes to confirm the modification. The logic editor status bar now shows not built. To build this change, I'll select the build menu and we must select build changes to avoid going offline. And we'll click OK here. Now to show that the process worked, I'll open the derived variables folder. We'll scroll down and find tank 1 volume. Here it is, tank 1 underscore volume. There are limitations to be aware of when editing objects and variables online. First, existing objects and variables cannot be renamed while online. So it's important to verify that any new object names are correct before building. Existing object logic variable types cannot be changed while online, so again, verify these details beforehand. Objects cannot be deleted during an online editing session. You'll either need to leave them unused or do an offline write that will momentarily stop the logic execution. Also, editing of derived data types in Logic Editor that affect Remote Connect objects cannot be done online. One additional tip is that if you only need a variable in Logic Editor, as it's not connected to either physical I/O or a protocol data point, just create it in the Elementary Variables folder. This makes it simpler to manage. To be able to upload an application from the SCADAPack to Remote Connect in the future, you'll want to write the logic source updates to the RTU after online changes are done. This can be very helpful if the configuration files were accidentally not saved, or if you don't currently have access to them. Writing the logic source is an online action that does not disturb normal operation of the SCADAPack. If you've done online edits in this programming session, navigate to the Online Diags SPX70 Controller tab. A dialog will appear, and you can click the Write Logic Source Now button. Writing the logic source, which is an archive file, to the SCADAPack can be done at any time while online. This presumes that for some reason it was not done after previous online edits were made, which might have been hours or months ago. To do so, first go online with Remote Connect, and then select the Online Diags SPX70 Controller tab. Now select the Logic tab, and press the Write Logic Source button. I had made an online edit earlier by creating the new Tank 1 volume object, but I didn't write the logic source at that time, so I'll do it now. I'm online with the SCADAPack, so I'll just go to the Online Diags SPX70 Controller tab. I'll select the Logic tab below that, and then click Write Logic Source. Now let's move on to editing logic in Logic Editor. First, as with adding objects, put Remote Connect and Logic Editor online. Next, we'll verify that the online and offline configurations are the same by verifying that you don't see different in either status bar. Now, in Logic Editor, you can begin editing. You can do many things, including adding, editing, or deleting functions and function blocks, adding, rearranging, or deleting logic sections. We can create and edit DFBs or delete unused DFBs. We can create or edit elementary variables or delete unused elementary variables. And we can also create and edit derived data types and delete unused derived data types. A few pointers to consider when doing online editing. First, after you confirm a modification, you'll see that any animation in the logic section is disabled until after the edit is complete. There's no need to build changes with every edit made. You can make multiple edits and then build changes when you're done. Remember to select OK at the prompt, "Do you want to apply online modification now?" Clicking cancel will bump you offline and your edits would be lost. And after you're done with online edits, RemoteConnect will prompt you to write the logic source file. You can do it at that time or choose to do it later if you'll be doing more editing. Logic Editor has its own help documentation. Its functionality is shared with Control Expert, which is used to program Moticon PLCs. So some of the documentation is specific to Moticon. However, there is still a lot of useful information. I'll go to the Help dialog index, and on the Contents tab, I'll select SCADAPack X70 Logic Editor, Operating Modes, then General, then Global Project Management, then Project Management, and finally Allowed Online Modifications. To more easily find this page again, you can go to the Favorites tab and click Add. The information in the table towards the bottom of this page can provide guidance on many advanced issues. Now I'll demonstrate a few typical online edits. First, back in RemoteConnect, I'll go online. And once we're online, we can see that different does not show up in the status bar. So I'll move to Logic Editor, and in the mode menu, I'll select Connect. And again, here we can see equal. We do not see different. I've got an application running in this RTU. So we'll open it up and we can see there is animation. But what to do if the application in the RTU and RemoteConnect do not match? Well, maybe someone forgot to save the application after making previous changes. To avoid any issues, the most likely solution would be to do a read in RemoteConnect to synchronize the two. After downloading the online version, though, remember to save it with a new version number or different name. I'd like to change the digital output this AND block controls. So I'll double-click on the output, and I want it to control pump 2 OK dot value instead. I'll click Yes to confirm the modification. Notice the animation goes away. Now to build it, we go to the Build menu and select Build Changes, or we could just type Control B. I'll confirm this, and we can see that the animation returns. Going back to RemoteConnect, we can see the message about the old logic source file having been deleted. It reminds me that I can write the latest source file by going to Online Diags and the Logic tab, or I could just click Write Logic Source Now, if that was the last edit I needed to do. After that's done, we'd probably want to save the application. Next, a slightly more involved online edit. I'm going to right-click on the Logic folder and create a new logic section. I'll call it Storage. And for simplicity, I'll use Function Block Diagram. And the new section opens. I'll insert a subtract function block by typing Control I and type SUB. Now I want to calculate how much volume remains in tank 1. Its full volume is 100, so I'm going to subtract the actual value of tank 1 level from the value 100, tank 1 level dot value, and then we're going to create a new elementary variable called tank 1 ullage. I'll click the check mark. The dialog pops up asking me if I really want to create a new variable. It detects that it should be of type real. I'll click Yes. Now that we've created this new logic section and function block, we'll type Control B to build this logic. And click OK. And there we go. So now I've created a logic section, I've inserted a function block, and I've created an elementary variable. I've built the changes and confirmed that modification. I could perform more online edits, or I could write the logic source to the RTU and save the application now if I'm done. But I'll do one more online edit before wrapping up. I'll open the Derived Data Types folder and create a new derived data type. I'll name this structure Customer. Yes, we confirm the modification. Now I'll add a few variables into this structure. First, I'll create a variable within the structure called name. We'll assign this a data type of string. Then I'll add one called age, and we will make this an integer. And we could add a third one. We could call this one address. And we'll create this one as a string again. Now that I've got that done, I'll build changes, Control B. I can now use this derived data type in further online edits. Now, as I'm done online editing, I'll go back to Remote Connect. And in Remote Connect, it's prompting me to write the logic source now. As I'm done with editing, I will write it now. Remember that if for any reason in the past, the logic source file was not written to the SCADAPack, you can go to the Logic tab and click the Write Logic Source button. Finally, I'll click the Save button to save the updated application to my computer. Just before closing, here are a few points to remember. Every time either the Remote Connect configuration or the logic is modified online, the stored logic source or archive file in the RTU is deleted. So it's a good idea to write the logic source file to the SCADAPack when you're done with online modifications. This allows reading the application from the RTU later if for any reason the Remote Connect application files are not available. Still, remember to save the Remote Connect files and store them in a location where they can be found when needed again. To learn more about the SCADAPack, access the user documentation on the Schneider Electric Exchange Shop and Schneider Electric website. Also, see our videos on YouTube.